I was not going to take mine. It was just like, I got so much shit now.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
It's a plastic version, but it
doesn't
works.
Doesn't matter. It works. We've used this sucker before. I forgot about it. And see what it says?
Yep. What do we got? Got it.
So, if you have one of these, makes it easier. What you need is a boy to be of assistance, and he needs to take a fish off.
Okay.
What fish?
Is that me? That would be me.
That's you.
That would be you.
So you're fishing, man. You're in charge.
I thought it was Mark.
Oh, no. Mark is long past being the boy.
All right. All right. I'm gonna put some gloves on here, guys. Sorry.
Oh, Beeplewitz. Is Beeplewitz here?
Yeah,
just take
yeah,
the top
yeah.
one. Take the top one.
This one?
Yeah. We start with the littlest.
Yeah, it'll be easier.
And we leave you the bigger ones.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to teach you how to do this.
All right.
You turn. No. Put your hand here. Open that. That fish turns around.
Put his mouth in there.
Bottom jaw.
Open up, buddy. Right there.
That's where it goes. Center it.
Right there.
And that's the way it goes.
Okay.
That fish is ready. Here's what I do. Other guys are going to do it differently. I can probably stick one of these under there. But the first thing that I do, and you need to have at least three guys to make this thing work.
Well, of course.
Otherwise, it doesn't work.
It's more fun with three.
Yeah, more funner. All right. The first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to cut the spine at the back of the head. It's hard here, even though this looks like it ends here. There's a little bit of flesh here, but right where you feel the back of the skull.
Okay.
And what you do is this.
Oh.
Yeah. See, this one isn't. Because if it's not, the first thing you do is break the spine.
Okay. And now he's dead.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, buddy.
Or at least he's... won't move anymore.
Yeah. I don't know if he's dead. But... All right. So the first thing that I do is I make two cuts, one on either side of this dorsal fin, all the way to the end, which goes back to here. And you do it on the other side. And then you can, and it goes, you have to go fairly deep like this. You have to be careful here because you will cut your fingers.
Okay.
You know how sharp you thought that knife was?
Not sharp enough.
Not sharp enough.
Shit. Sharper, the better.
Yeah, it can't be too sharp.
No, it cannot be too sharp.
So I told you, 11 degree angle.
Right.
And push and pull. Push, turn over, and pull. Push, turn over, and pull. Push, turn over, and pull.
Okay.
See if that works.
Yeah. That's more better.
And so you're just going parallel with the fin. That way you're leaving as little meat on this thing as possible. You've gone past the end. And this goes down just about to the backbone. And you're not cutting the thing in half if you can avoid it. Put my thumb on it.
And rip. Okay.
Okay, and that's what it looks like.
Right.
Now, you look in here. Put your, whatever you got in your hand.
Yeah.
And run your thumb along there.
just so you get to feel what I'm looking for. That's the top of the spine.
All right.
Okay, and you want it cut on both sides.
All right, so we're going to take this. This side is always the easiest to do for a right-hander.
Okay.
Because it lays over, and then you're working this way.
Gotcha.
But again, this is still not sharp enough.
I thought it was brand new.
Brand new is not sharp at all.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's got a factory edge on it. And you're doing this all the time.
Sharper, the better.
Did you hear what Mr. Franzen had to say?
Sharper, the better.
It'll take you a couple years to get this thing down to where it's like a razor.
Okay.
I'm still not sharp. You'll grow to love this knife. And when it looks really beat to hell, that's when it's in really good shape.
Right.
Those are made to do one thing.
That's exactly right. All right, so what I'm doing is I'm cutting right along the side of the spine. See what I'm doing? There's no meat left on here. That's what you really want.
All right.
Now, you're not going to do that, but you're trying not to leave any meat behind. That's the perfect fillet. Leaves almost nothing. And then this is where you got to be careful. See, this is the rib bone that I'm at now. The one that goes around the innards. And what I'm doing is the knife is against those ribs. Go away.
Come here, go get some bug spray.
I've got some down on them both there. Yeah, let's spray out. Because they're brutal.
See what I'm doing though? I'm doing a slice, but not hard. Because what I don't want to do is I don't want to just go through those ribs.
Okay.
We're leaving all the bones together. See what I'm doing? I'm pushing this open. And don't cut your fingers here because it's real easy to do. And all we're doing is pulling the flesh away.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's take a pause.
Well, no, just keep working here, man.
Well, let's get the
spray.
You've
got to work in adversity.
Let's get some spray on you. I'm going to pause for 1 second. All right?
It's okay with me.